this kitchen, with that window, how many hours were wasted from simply losing track of time? Hey, don't feel bad. In the end, it all comes down to your own choices. It's been a while since the last time we spoke. How's your mental fortitude these days? I barely even remember how it works. What I do remember is that things like this tend to be very personal. I assume that some actions which others would find relaxing might be horribly demanding. I suppose that in order to get to know you better, I would need to learn what actions are good for you and which ones aren't. I feel like I need that, if I am to remember. Forcing yourself to think about difficult things come at a momentary risk. You're likely to lose some of your current fortitude, but you will probably also increase the amount you receive long term. If you don't eat regularly, you'll simply starve. Starving increases all the negative effects on your mental fortitude. Just keep that in mind. Thank you. quiet as usual. Your living room. Sometimes you just need a break to regain your strength. Exhaustion, the natural result of not sleeping enough. Negative impacts on your mental fortitude will be greater when you're tired. Please remember to sleep for both our sakes. Maybe you would feel better if you got some sleep. Your bathroom. That shower is a godsend on stressful days. If you don't clean yourself daily, your colleagues might notice. Reeking with foul odors will worsen all losses of your mental fortitude. Showering regularly is the only sure way to avoid that. You seem tired. today. Misery. The temptation of staying home is oppressive. Work starts at 8 and it takes you about 30 minutes to get there. Leave before 7:30 to be sure you make it on time. Oh, right, one more thing. Don't forget about your plans for Saturday. Go on, get yourself something to eat. I'm stuck with remembering this now. Don't expect to get away with failure. I remember now. It seems like such a long time ago since I was here. I wanted to look back on this part of my life, to try and understand what happened to me, what happened with you, the old me who would hide behind concrete walls, who didn't dare talk to anyone about his problems. But now I remember why I changed. I promise I will never forget. Never again. Even when it's raining, she's still there. Probably waiting for someone. That's very kind of her. Hope whoever she's waiting for has the decency to bring an umbrella. You need to get a grip on your sleeping schedule. You're exhausted. So, what do you want to do this evening? Play some games? Watch TV? Those are supposed to be fun, right? Now that I think about it, back when we first met, I feel like you talked me into thinking that they're all just pointless ways of wasting time. Do you still feel like that? Tuesday. Tired. Like a slightly more sluggish Monday, if you can believe it. For now, just aim for Saturday. Try to get back to your routine. It might help. And don't miss work. Try to reach out to your colleagues while at work. It's the main way for you to increase your mental fortitude. Or at least, that's what I suppose. I also assume that there are risks involved. Things can't always go your way, you know. You used to spend hour upon hour staring out through that window. What did you see that was so captivating? I remember the first time we entered this apartment. Back when we'd just got to know each other. You just walked straight up to that window and looked outside. At that moment, I could sense a faint rush of excitement. Did you like the view? guy at the table is back. Must be his favourite spot. I wonder who he's texting with. A friend? Family member? Or maybe he's just browsing the web. Wednesday. Why? Halfway to what exactly? Rest? A break? Are you starting to realize that this week is no different from any other? Thank you. You need a shower. Seriously, what are you doing with your life? Leave home now. Sometimes you can lie to yourself, enough for it to sound reasonable. Sometimes it's born from an experience which etches itself in like a trauma. If someone asks you to come to a party, the healthy way to respond would be to trust that the person asking actually wants you to come. He's only asking to be polite. I don't belong in that crowd anyway. But then you decide to go because secretly you still want to. You find yourself sitting quietly in the middle of a filled room, wondering if it would be okay for you to speak. But everyone is talking and you don't want to be rude, because then you might not get invited anymore. So you just sit there with your ugly fake smile. See the guy with the cigarette down near the doors to the right? I feel like we see him here almost every day. He never does anything but smoke. This isn't cutting it. Get some sleep. You need it. this late and he still goes out to have a smoke. I suppose it works as a stress reliever, trading life to take the edge off. Can you blame him?